She slept when we went.
Never mind. You two go and help Gussie in the kitchen. Now, Mr. Padelford, we'll talk about the painting.
Okay.
I had some samples. Oh, here we are. Now, first, the living room. I want it to be a soft green.
Uh-huh.
Not as blue-green as a robin's egg.
No.
But not as yellow-green as daffodil buds.
Uh-huh.
Now, the only sample I could get is a little too yellow. But don't let whoever does it go to the other extreme and get it too blue.
No.
It should just be a sort of grayish-yellow-green.
Uh-huh.
Now, the dining room. I'd like yellow. Not just yellow, a very gay yellow. Something bright and sunshiny.
Uh-huh.
I tell you, Mr. Padelford, if you'll send one of your workmen to the grocer for a pound of their best butter and match that exactly, you can't go wrong.
Uh-huh.
Now, this is the paper we're going to use in the hall. It's flowered, but I don't want the ceiling to match any of the colors of the flowers.
No.
There's some little dots in the background, and it's these dots I want you to match. Not the little greenish dot near the hollyhock leaf.
No.
But the little bluish dot between the rosebud and the delphinium blossom. Is that clear?
Uh-huh.
Now, the kitchen's to be white. Not a cold, antiseptic hospital white.
No.
A little warmer, but still, not to suggest any other color but white.
Uh-huh.
Now, for the powder room, in here, I want you to match this thread, and don't lose it. It's the only spool I have, and I had an awful time finding it. As you can see, it's practically an apple red, somewhere between a healthy wine sap and an unripened Jonathan.
Uh-huh.
Oh, excuse me.
You got that, Charlie?
Red, green, blue, yellow, white.
Check.